Solar Street, everybody. I hope you had a good week. I hope you've stayed cool. It has been crazy hot the past couple of days, and I haven't even wanted to go outside. It's yuck, but hopefully you're doing well. I've enjoyed seeing some of you, and hopefully I'll get to see more of you soon. But we've been talking about Joshua and the nation of Israel after God let them go into the promised land, and he told them to conquer it, to take it over, because it was the land that he had promised Abraham. And while Joshua was alive, Israel did a good job of listening to God. They obeyed. They would make mistakes, but then they would fix them. They would ask for forgiveness, and they did pretty good. But then Joshua got old, and it was time for Joshua to die. And he told Israel, look, you guys are going to have to decide who you're going to serve. Are you going to serve God, or are you going to be persuaded by the people in the land that you haven't conquered yet? So I gave you guys, some of you have already come to church and have gotten one of these books. If you haven't, you're going to get one when you come. Your family will. And it has a lot of really cool pictures and things in it that help us understand what's going on in the story. And so what we can see is there's some parts that have some maps in them. And the maps show us the promised land that God promised Israel, and the different places inside that promised land where God told each of the 12 tribes of Jacob to live. So they weren't going to all live in the exact same place. They were supposed to fill the promised land. And each of them had a place that was designated for them. And they were supposed to go to that place, and they were supposed to conquer and defeat the people that lived there. Okay? And Joshua warned them. He said, you need to do what God told you to do. You do not need to go in and let the people persuade you not to punish them. Because what's going to happen is you're going to get used to them. You're going to become friends with them. They're going to become friends with you. You're going to marry their daughters. They're going to marry your daughters. You're going to start worshiping their gods. And it's not going to be good. God's going to have to punish you the same way he's asking you to punish these nations. And they said, oh, Joshua, we won't do that. We won't do that. We promise that we will do what God told us to do. And then Joshua died. And so they started out okay. They all spread out to their land where God told them to go in the promised land, and they started to fight the people. But in little places here and there, there were people that they just decided, I'm not going to fight these people. They're okay. They're not bothering anybody. We're not going to fight them. And they let them live. And the Bible says that these people began to become friends with them, and they began to marry each other's daughters, and then they began to worship each other's gods. And so the book of Judges is what comes in the Bible next. Books of the Bible. And the next book is the book of Judges. And in Judges, it tells us what happened after Joshua died in the promised land. And what happened is a cycle. A cycle is something that repeats itself over and over and over again. And the book of Judges tells us that what happened is because the nation of Israel decided not to punish all of the people, they let some people live. The Bible tells us that they would be okay, they would be worshiping God, but then they would start to add the idols of the people around them. So they would worship God and the idols. And then they would start paying more attention to the idols and the people and the culture around them. And so God, keeping his promise, because he's a promise keeper, would punish them. And the way he would punish them is he would allow people to come and conquer Israel and those nations. And he would enslave them. They would become slaves again like they were in Egypt for a period of time until they understood that it was happening to them because they had broken their promise to God. And when they would realize, it would many times be years after they had been slaves, they would realize, oh no, we made a mistake. We broke our promise to God and we started worshiping other idols. So then they would pray to God and say, God, we have sinned. Please forgive us. Please deliver us. And God would listen to their prayer. He would forgive, because they were asking for forgiveness. And he would send them what the Bible calls a judge. So this would be a person who was born in Israel that would listen to God. God would appoint this person to be the leader and to judge Israel for their sin and to help Israel judge the nation that was keeping them slaves. Kind of like when they judged Egypt. And so when the judge would be appointed over Israel, Israel would listen to the judge. Israel would do what the judge told them to do. They would fight the people who were keeping them slaves. They would find their deliverance, and then they would obey the judge as long as the judge lived. And then when the judge would die, guess what Israel would do? They would go right back to worshiping idols. And then they would go right back into being slaves. And then they'd go right back to praying for deliverance, and God would send them another judge. And this happened over and over and over again, kind of like when Israel was in the desert and they kept saying, why did we leave Egypt? Why couldn't we just die? Okay, just like when they would do that over and over and over again, and they didn't learn their lesson. They didn't learn to love and trust and obey God all the time. And so it happens over and over again. It's very frustrating to read because you're thinking, why are you doing this again? Why are you doing this again? But if we're honest, guys, do we do the same mistakes over and over again? Do we disobey our parents and then we get in trouble and then we say we're sorry and mom and dad forgive us and maybe they punish us a little bit, but they forgive us. But then another day or two later, what do? We disobey mom and dad again, don't we? We are people who sin and we make mistakes. And without the Holy Spirit helping us, we're going to make that mistake over and over and over again. But God has promised that Jesus would die on the cross, and he did, and he paid for our sin. And he also promised to send the Holy Spirit to live inside our hearts to help us not continue to make the same mistakes over and over and over again. Okay, so we need to learn from the Bible stories. We don't need just to read them and think that they're interesting. We need to learn from them. We need to learn to listen to the Holy Spirit, who will not die and leave us like the judges would die and leave Israel. Okay, but we're going to be studying about these judges for the next several weeks. Okay, so in that book, we have a list of who the judges are that we're going to learn about. And it also shows us the cycle that Israel would repeat over and over and over again. So if you want to look in the book, you can see who we're going to be studying about next. Okay? And I'll tell you what, these are some of the coolest stories in the Bible. And if you ask me, they're weird, they're strange. You're like, this really happened? But yes, it really did. And some really cool people, really cool judges. And the things that God helped them do were really, really cool. And so I'm excited about the stories we're going to learn about. But remember, we don't just want to learn stories. We want to learn what they can teach us. And they need to teach us that we need to listen to the Holy Spirit. And we need to obey God. And we need to try not to make the same mistake over and over and over again. I will see you next week when we will start with the very first judge. And it will be fun. I will talk to you later.